bonke lapha emakhaya nibukele unqa phambili wenu SABC 1 Mzansi for sure. Igama nguSiyabonga Isibongo ngumdlalose. Namhlanje ngiza kunina ngisendaweni enhle nokuthula eyaziwa ngokuthi iHillcrest eKwaZulu Natal. Ngizohlangana nensizwe igama lakhe ke uAaron. Yena ke uthendene nathi ngoba ene quest athi kasimsize ngayo. Ake sixoxisane nasizwe ukuthi ke insizwe singakusiza ngayo.
How you doing, mate?
Good, and you?
Good. That looks a bit delicious.
Basically, it's called tomato concassé with spaghetti and I have meatballs. Beef meatballs. It's very fresh Italian dish. And it's, I mean, it's, this is my type of cooking.
Yes.
So I just have some mozzarella cheese.
Okay, so go for it, please.
All right, cool.
Okay, cool.
I give you 10 out of 10 for this. So Aaron, tell me a bit about yourself. Who is Aaron?
I was born in Chatsworth. My grandmother was a cook and my chef, sorry, and my father was also a chef. And obviously I picked up that sort of trade and stuff. And I mean, I've been cooking from the time I was 13 years.
Oh.
And I decided to come to 1000 Hills Chef School.
What are your hobbies? What do you get up to if you're not cooking?
I play the drums. I play for the church, my church that I go to. It's just music and food that I'm into.
You know, you seem very comfortable around the kitchen.
Yeah.
What does it mean for you being in this space?
I mean, it's passion. It's like, I just absolutely love cooking. So yes. I'll do anything to be in the kitchen.
Because there's a lot of male chefs. And yeah. They say that the best chefs right now in the world and the best cooks are males.
I mean, that's pretty true.
Oh, you agree with that one?
Yeah, I
so how did you get involved, you know, with cooking?
Started off with my dad cooking in the kitchen and yes. Then he would call me and he would tell me to chop an onion or chop some garlic for him. Then I sort of pick up this passion. And then I just started cooking at the age of 13. I used to cook suppers every day at home.
13?
Yeah, that's how I picked it up. Basically from my father and my grandmother.
Yeah. Do you remember the first meal you prepared?
It was a potato curry.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
How did it come out?
Oh, it came out absolutely boss, like my mother absolutely enjoyed it.
You've got a quest that you'd like us to help you out with.
Yeah.
So tell me a bit about your quest.
I only know Italian, French foods, like Mediterranean, European foods.
Yes.
But as an Indian, like I really don't know about my background of Indian cuisine. It's my culture, I feel like.
Yes.
Like I'm Indian. And
yeah.
And like it's really good to know about my background and stuff. It gives me a reason to learn more about my Indian background. And I would really like to learn about the history behind the spices and what it does for our body.
So, I love your quest.
Okay.
Not because it has to do with food, because you know I love my food. But because it's something different about it. And I really want to go on this journey with you to learn a bit more about Indian cuisine. But before we hit our journey and to get going about your quest, we need to get permission from an elder.
Okay.
Who are we going to get permission from?
My dad and my mom.
Please pack your stuff, take whatever you need. Let's go see your folks. And get your quest started.
Nice.
But before we go there, let me dig in one more time.
Go for it.
Cool. It's a pity to let good food go to waste, man. Maybe you said.
This is Sia. He's from SABC One Kulcha Kwest.
Hello, Sia.
I've written to them about my quest to going to find out more about Indian cuisine. Thank you for sending me to chef school, and I'm really passionate about food and stuff, and I really want to learn about my culture and Indian cuisine and stuff, and I'm here to ask for permission to go on this quest.
Well, I don't have a problem. It's a good thing. It's gonna open many doors for him to learn about his culture and the cuisine and the industry.
I'm glad that he's gonna be entering the field. I know he's gonna do well.
What are your guys, your earliest memories about him wanting to cook? Because he says he's learned the art of cooking from home.
I'll tell you about when he was little.
Yes.
Making mud cakes.
Oh, okay.
Mud cakes and cooking leaves and stuff. But other than that, he was always in the kitchen trying to prepare things, different ingredients with different types of foods.
Yes.
And it did come out good.
Yes, whenever I was in the kitchen, he'll always come and assist me and want to learn about, you know, the ingredients and how to prepare it, even with my mom as well. When I saw him always showing interest and passion when I was cooking in the kitchen, I realized that, you know, he's kind of gifted in this area, and whatever I taught him, he always tried to put his own twist to it and modernize the dish and fuse it with other things, so
yes.
So I kind of knew that, you know, he'll take a liking to the food industry.
Aaron, your folks have given you permission to go on this quest with us. Sir, I'm looking forward to being on this quest with you. This is my Kulcha Kwest ticket that I'm giving to you. So this means our journey has begun. Your quest, my good man, starts right now. You have been Kulcha Kwest. There you go. Please go pack up. Let's get ready to hit the road and start your quest.
Okay, mom, dad, I'm all packed up, ready to go. Can I have your blessings?
Mom and dad and little sister, we're not taking him too far. Okay. We're just taking him, you know, just downtown, okay. Morningside, right, to go meet a great friend of ours. This man apparently specializes in Indian cuisine food as well. Right. He's got a restaurant and he's been in this business for years. So it's Mr. Mali's. It's not too far from here. So that's where he'll be getting his teaching.
We know that you're going to do very well in what you've set out to do. And we send you with our blessings. Okay. Whatever you put your hand to, I believe that God will bless you. You'll have success and a lot of favor in whatever you're going to do.
Came here today because of this young man over here. Aaron, this is Mr. Mali.
Welcome, Aaron. You're free to talk to me, yeah, because you are a youngster, upcoming chef. You'll have a fantastic time with us. We will guide you. See, I am in this business the last 15 years in South Africa. Previously, I owned other two restaurants. Now, this is a third one. All the dishes which is available in India, we try to serve here. You, as a young chef, young upcoming budding chef, you'll have a fantastic experience with us. You know, our Indian food, every Indian spice, what we put in our food, it has got a medicinal value. You aware of it?
Never hear of it, never.
For example, the garlic, it has got a medicinal value. It cut the cholesterol and also prevents the cancer in your stomach, especially even turmeric. It has been proven. It has got a chemical which stops the cancer cell, growth of cancer cell.
Wow.
Even cinnamon. Cinnamon is very good for diabetic people. I have four chefs from India. Mm-hmm. The one guy from South India who is do all the dosas and all those South Indian dishes. The guy from Bangalore who do all the, like a dal, all that North Indian dishes. Also, I have a chef from Calcutta and New Delhi. They do the non-bread and Indo-Chinese, all at least 15 to 20 years experience in their field. And I'll take you inside and I'll show you how they make one dish, so you can even learn from them and you can even do yourself. I'm going to take him to the kitchen. Are you ready?
Really excited. Ready.
Guys, have fun. Aaron, you find me here.
Thank you.
Have fun in the kitchen, yeah? Hi, yeah. Skolo sesiqalile-ke baba. Athungena straight kwi frying pan. Insizwe ye kitchen yokhombisa ukuthi idume ngani.
So Mali, so today I'm going to be cooking something called a chicken escalope. So it's basically a cut of meat that's similar to a scallop size, basically round. It's going with sauteed potatoes, cherry tomatoes, some onions and stuff, and a balsamic reduction. Now balsamic vinegar, it's quite a strong vinegar, and basically I'm going to reduce it to a nice sticky glaze. There you have it, that's your chicken escalope.
I want you to do one of your speciality, or chettinad, South Indian dish, chettinad prawns. And he's going to watch and he's going to learn and he's going to do for you. I want you to watch and I want to see how you can do it tomorrow. I'll give you 24 hours to do it. I know you're coming to an Indian kitchen first time in your life. This curry goes well with the non-bread, Indian bread. Yeah. Like, you know, our master, Balai Das, he is our tandoori man. He's going to make one bread for you, how they make the bread. And I wanted to taste that non-bread with that curry. Okay. This is a tandoori oven which we imported from India. It's just a clay pot, you know.
Okay. Yeah.
The clay pot built in like a case, you know, in between to, it actually keeps the heat. They cook in this, like see how he's adding that in the dough, made especially dough, pre-made dough to make the bread. The plain naan bread, the CBU, this is a vegetarian, see, like without egg also, they make it.
Okay.
This is called it's called butter naan. They put a spoon of butter is applied, and then the chef says this will go well with the your curry. Will you able to do this dish tomorrow?
Yeah, huh? Work.
You want to take up a challenge?
Definitely.
Okay.
The food is ready now. I think we are going to taste the food in the dining hall. Yeah. The chef, we are going to bring the food to the dining hall, okay?
Okay.
Now the what you made, I want you to taste.
I mean,
this is made by Aaron.
Alrighty.
Okay, this is a Mediterranean dish.
It's quite a small meal. I don't know if guys as big as myself will be full for me.
But it's a starter. And it's a starter dish.
Yeah.
I'm loving the chicken.
Okay, let me taste how you made it.
Mm-hmm.
Amazing, man. But it's very mild. You're going to try that Indian chettinad prawns. Mr. Shia, try that how it is, the prawn. We can.
So this is a prawn curry?
Prawn curry, the prawn chettinad. It's a place called Chettinad in southern part of India.
Yes.
They can able to put cashews and almonds, all the paste, it's all added in this. So it's spicy, but it's not hot.
Okay.
I want to try it.
Doesn't have that extra kick.
No?
Yeah. Okay. Mr. Mali, thank you very much for your time. I really enjoy the food. It's a bit hot, but I'm getting there.
This is a South Indian.
This is a South Indian.
Yeah, I will have to. Next time when you come, I'm going to give you a North Indian dish. It's more mild. And
why do Indians like spices? Like, where did spices originate?
Story most of the spices it grown in India,
okay.
Especially in southern part of India. There's a place called Kerala where the cardamom, clove, and cinnamon all grown there. Also the northeastern part of India, okay? So the most of all the spices, it came from our elderly people, forefathers, because the Indian believe every food what he eat has got some value in you,
okay.
Medicinal value. Yes. It's not just to live, our part of our culture, you can say.
Yes, sir.
Spice.
Mr. Mali, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
And let me spend time with this young man.
Okay.
Yes, sir. I'm leaving him under your guidance, but let me chat to him quickly before I sign him off to you again. How's your day been so far?
Been really good. I mean, I've learned so much from Mr. Mali.
So, but would you cope if they said to you, please come work here?
Yeah, I'll definitely cope. I'll cope in any kitchen. I mean, because I have really good passion for food. And
yeah.
Like, I think I'll work in any kitchen,
yes,
as long
sir.
As I get to cook.
As long as you get to cook.
Yeah.
Mr. Mali gave you an overnight challenge that he wants you to do. Do you think you'll be able to top this?
Yeah, definitely.
Are you sure?
Yeah, definitely can. Basics, really basic ingredients, basic preparation.
Okay. I hope when I taste it as well, it will come out better.
I'll just make it mild for you.
You'll make it mild? Oh, you're making fun of me right now. Okay. I went through a bit, you know, just searched on the internet as well, because I was trying to get a bit more knowledge as well about, you know, the different types of food, especially yeah. Indian cuisines as well. They were saying here that you really sometimes don't have to be restricted and just sticking to making, you know, the same dish using the same patterns as how you've been told as well. You can also play around with spices and herbs.
Yeah.
So I hope you can do that as well.
Yeah, definitely.
But just remember the importance of those spices and some of the herbs
yeah.
and the purpose that they can do in our bodies as well.
Yeah. See, with my cooking, it's quite modern. So I mix spices up with different cuisines.
Yes.
It's called fusion cooking. So like I'll be doing like some Italian dish and I'll infuse Indian spices in there. So that's the way I cook.
Yeah.
It's very modern.
I'm looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to it. Aaron, thank you very much, my good man.
Thank you, see ya.
Enjoy the rest of your day.
You too.
I'll see you tomorrow. So Aaron.
Hey, how's it here?
How you doing, man?
Good and you?
How'd you sleep?
I slept very well. Yeah, I did a lot of research and stuff.
So yesterday you were given an overnight task that you need to do and you had to prepare something.
Yeah.
How did that go?
Yeah, it was a bit of a struggle. Like, I actually forgot what to do, and then I had to do research and stuff, and I had to learn about different spices and the taste and
yeah.
and stuff.
Okay. Are you sure that it's going to come out the way Mr. Mali likes it?
I hope so. Really hope so.
But everything looks perfectly fine.
How are you, Aaron?
Good morning to you.
Morning to you.
How are you?
How are you doing, Mr. Mali?
Let's taste it and see and try it. Put your Indian traditional outfit.
So must you go change quickly?
Yes.
Okay, yes. Please go away that. So, Mr. Mali, everything looks very nice here. Yeah? It looks similar to how you made it yesterday.
I have to taste the curry and tell how it
is. It's not only just about the look.
Yeah, not only the look, unless I taste it.
If it's meant to taste like yours, What taste are we looking for? Because I can eat it and think it tastes good.
No, like it's authentic. All the spice all in a correct proposition. Oh, okay. Like it put on that curry.
Welcome, Arun. How are you?
Good.
And you look terrific, man. Like one bridegroom, not as a cook.
Ah, so this is what
traditional Indian outfit.
Yes. How do you feel, man?
I feel different. I never won this before.
You've never won it before?
Yeah, I don't feel myself.
You don't feel yourself? So it's your first time for everything?
Yeah.
This outfit normally is one of the a traditional dress for wedding reception. The curry looks nice, but I have to taste and see what he has passed his taste of what. It look very nice, but I can find, you put, I think, a little extra butter inside. Let me taste the curry, how it looks, how it tastes.
Butter.
Yeah.
That spice, everything is all right. Mm-hmm. I think you have put salt a little bit extra here.
Okay.
You put twice here.
Okay.
Otherwise, the curry is okay.
So generally, how much would one be?
They used to put about, for one portion, say about half a spoon, half a teaspoon of salt. I think you put twice.
Okay. Well, out of 10, how much do you give him?
I can give out of 10, 8.
8?
Yeah.
That's not bad.
That's an A.
That's a good score, man. Mr. Mali, this man is here to spend time with you.
Yes.
You're still going to take him through different lessons. I will leave you two to get on with the work. So, I'll see you later.
I'm going to ask my chef to make another dish, chicken pepper fry. I wanted to look at it, and then I want to ask you what you can do, you know, whether you learn the both and you want to use it. Can I ask Jaydev? Come and you do the chicken pepper fry for him. So, he wants to see another dish from you. And Aaron is going to help you in the kitchen to put the thing. What he must do first?
Two spoons of oil.
Yeah. Okay.
Medium
the oil must be get the medium hot. Okay. Chopped garlic, about
one spoon. Half a spoon ginger chopping.
Just garnish with a little bit of coriander. And your chicken pepper fry is ready. You learned how to make that chettinad prawn curry and a chicken pepper fry. Shall we taste? Can I taste it and see how it is, and how you taste and see how it is?
Very nice. I can get the spices and stuff coming through.
Is it very hot or very spicy?
It's quite mild.
Mild.
It's very powerful with the spices that you put in.
Yes. Very, very tasty, yeah?
Yes.
Because if you want more hot, I think as the chef told you, put extra black pepper powder.
Yeah.
Aaron, we taught you how to do it. You watch everything. So I want to just mix what we taught you and what you know. We are going to open a restaurant for the public. So they will be working. They are going to prepare themselves. But you be comfortable and do your own work.
Insizwa isizilungiselela ukwenza i-reveal. Hake sibone ukuthi umehlanganisa indlela ke yena le afunde engakhona ukupheka. Ngale ndlela le ayifundiswe ngayo ke la ekhaya. Uzoke apheke into enjani ke.
Hello, hi guys. I'm Aaron. So I had to come up with a dish for Mr. Mari. Well, basically what he has taught me, and to infuse Indian cooking with what I know from the chef school. And yeah, this is what I've come up with, Mr. Mari. We enjoy it.
Looks awesome,
man. Yeah, it's something different. It's something that's mixed with different cultures and stuff.
What you will, what you learned here and what you know with that
exactly.
Combined in the fusion cook.
This is prawns with cashew nuts, and this is chicken chettinad.
Chicken
chettinad.
Oh, this is the one what we taught you.
Yeah, that's the one.
Okay. That's, you're tasting that.
That's very good.
Then that one is what is
it? It's chicken pepper fry.
Chicken pepper fry.
Chicken pepper fry.
The one that your chef taught me.
Okay, okay. Yeah.
Not, I'll let the experts taste first.
I can see some mushroom there.
Yeah.
So I can see some tomato.
So how did you fuse that with what you learned here, in the way that you usually normally prepare it?
Most of the stuff on the plate I learned from the chef school, like how to saute vegetables and stuff, and then obviously the Indian bajar and garam masala and stuff is obviously the influence that I've done here, like the spice and stuff. Like for example, I use jeera in my bajar mixture.
Yes.
That's one of the spices that I've learned about.
Yeah.
Well done, man.
Very good.
You really learned. Very good. Very good. Very good. I really.
Okay, thank you for teaching
I wish
me.
You best of luck in future. I think you learn very good. Within 24 hours, you learn something and you can able to produce a dish.
So now, for presentation and everything, how many are we giving them out of 10?
I can give you this as a 9 out of 10.
Now, you see, you keep going up the scales.
What, how many points you can give for this?
You know, for me, it tastes like lamb chops. Mm-hmm. And I think he did the job. I'll give him 10 out of 10 for that.
And the lady, how much do you give him?
10 out of 10. That's really good.
10 out of 10?
Yeah. I just want to say thank you for teaching me about like Indian cuisine and stuff.
So, Aaron, it's been a nice journey for you.
Right, it's really helpful.
I've had a good time being here as well. Mr. Mali, thank you very much for your time. I mean, the food has been superb. You've learned everything, yeah? You obviously want to go back to chef school.
Yeah.
I don't know, maybe you guys come exam time or something like that, or you have to show off your cooking skills. Will you add what you've learned here as well going forward?
Yeah, I definitely will.
What stood out for you in this quest when we were here and spending time here?
When Mr. Mali was explaining the nutritional value behind spices and what it does for your body and how it heals and stuff. I never knew that. I learned a lot.
Alrighty, my good man, I've had fun as well being here with you. I've learned a lot, Mr. Mali.
Thank you very much, yeah.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for coming through, man.
Thank you.
Thank you. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna be outside a little bit. I'm gonna give you a bit of time. You need to clean up all of this before you leave. But as well, just say goodbye to everybody and go thank the chefs as well and say goodbye to them. I'll be outside waiting for you.
I think everybody should always be creative and experiment and follow their desires as much as possible to make amazing presentations like this happen. The cuisine that he did was absolutely superb. I think he can continue doing this for the rest of his life.
Mbukela uhambo lalensizwa leli eselifike emaphethelweni. Into engithokoziseleke ngaloko engikubonile lapha ukuthi le ndoda le ifike lapha ayifundisa ke ngemvelaphi ukuthi ukudla kwamandiya kusukela kuphi, kwakuphekwa kanjani, futhi ke kungani ke kusetshenziswa ke zona ke lezi spices ezisetshenziswa laphayana. Ngithemba ukuthi sithokozele isiqephu sethu sanamhlanje. Uqhubeke ubukele iCulcha Kwest kwe-SABC 1 Msansi for sure. Same time, same place, next week uyazi asiqabele. For more information, visit our website on www.culturequest.co.za or drop us an email at culturequest@avuapds.co.za.